my channel. If you are new here, my name is Dee, aka The Messy Perfectionist, and my channel is a place where I like to share inspirational and personal growth life tips. I share healing and health tips. I am a certified holistic nutritionist as well as a certified life coach. Today I'm going to be sharing my 2-month post-op VSG update. If you are interested in learning a little bit more about that, please stay tuned. So I'll start with my weight loss progress, or lack thereof. I mentioned in my last video that I had kind of been in a little stall around Thanksgiving, and I had thought the scale started moving in the right direction. But alas, I have been bouncing back and forth between the same 2 to 4 pounds. It's been very frustrating. It has caused me frustration. I have been frustrated. I have been a little emotional about it because, as I mentioned, one of my fears, I mentioned this in a previous video, that one of my fears is that, you know, having done all this and just to have lost 30 pounds would be, you know, just short of devastational for me. In my 1-month update, I believe I lost about 30 pounds at that point. So I have lost between total now between 35 and 37 pounds. So for consistency's sake, we're just going to say around 35 pounds. So this month, I only lost like 5 or 6 pounds. Yeah. It's upsetting, especially when we look at other people, right? We start watching the videos and reading the blogs and all of those things, and it's just so different for everybody. You see people that drop like a ton of weight super fast, and then there's other people that do struggle. And I have met people that, you know, were at a weight loss stall for a month. So I know this isn't totally unusual. However, I have looked at what I have been doing and maybe things that I could be doing better or differently in that. So I'm going to share with you all of that stuff. So due to the holidays, like many of us, I too partook in the extra sugar. My daughter and I happily made Christmas cookies, which we made 3 batches over the last month. And we didn't eat 3 batches of cookies, you know, just me, my daughter, and my husband. I did share those cookies with friends and family and neighbors. However, you know, still having a cookie every day or every couple of days is probably something that I don't need to be doing, right? So I also, what else did I do? I also, you know, noticed that I had been eating a little bit more carbohydrates besides the cookies. I bought English muffins. My daughter loves English muffins and she's a super picky eater. So I would make an English muffin and she would eat half and then I would eat the other half. And I would have that for my lunch with an egg. I don't know if that's having some huge impact on causing a weight loss stall, but I need to, like I said, drop those simple carbs. I just don't need them right now and I need to do better, and I will do better going forward. I noticed that when I really looked at it, I have not been drinking enough water. I have a 32-ounce water bottle and I am certainly not filling that twice a day. So that's the other thing. Have I been protein focused? No, I really haven't been that protein focused when I'm eating cookies and I'm having half an English muffin, you know, on days. For Christmas, I made panna alla vodka. I am an Italian mama and I always cook too much food. So I tried to share my food with everybody. Please take it home with you. But, you know, we wound up with a lot of pasta left over. So I'm having, you know, my half a cup of pasta. You know, I don't know if I've had it every day since Christmas, but it's been pretty consistent. So, you know, even though it's a small amount, I'm still having a pasta every day. And that's not what I need to be doing. I also have not been measuring my food consistently, and that is something that I need to start doing again. When you measure your food all the time, you kind of know what it looks like in your bowl or your plate, right? But, you know, maybe just that extra couple bites is making a difference. Now, you can feel it at this point. I know down the road, you can stretch your pouch out a little bit, and of course, you want to avoid that as much as possible. And like my surgeon asked, when I was there for my 1 month, you know, how many ounces of food do you think you're eating? And, you know, he's like, I just, you know, you don't want it to creep up, basically. You know, you don't want it to go just, you know, okay, I'm having 4 ounces, now I'm having 6 ounces, and then you have 8 ounces. So, you know, it's just something to be really mindful of, especially right now. I'm still in the beginning stages of this, right? I'm only 2 months out. And I know that 35 to 37 pounds in 2 months is something that I should be very happy about. And I am. I still don't really fully see it in myself. I think I feel a little bit of a difference as far as going back to the gym. I'm not, say, hurting more than I was before, even though I was heavier and more fit when I was at the gym before. I definitely don't feel more fatigue or more pain, but that's a whole other thing. Going back to the gym and pushing myself a little bit more, I was really looking forward to doing some strength training, which I have not yet got back into because I am noticing that I'm having kind of that inflammation, which I tend to do when I start working out, and I retain a little bit more water, which is normal, right? When your muscles are healing, you're using your muscles, they are having small little tears in them, and water builds up around them to help heal, and you can retain water when you first start going back to the gym. So I've been taking a little slower than I wanted to, and I've been consistently doing elliptical or my, you know, treadmill, at least getting 40 minutes of exercise in when I go, which is about 3 to 4 times a week. And I've also been walking more often in the evening since the weather has been nicer here. And plus it's been kind of fun since, you know, everybody's house is decorated for Christmas. It's kind of been fun walking around. And the other thing I, food wise that I noticed that I, you know, started kind of increasing more was, you know, I got some of the holiday Coffee Mate creamer to share with people when they want to come over and have coffee. And then also for myself, having it in my decaf. Now, I'm not having a lot of it. I only put a little bit in with my Premier Protein, and that's my breakfast. So my Premier Protein is in my hot drink, is what I'm getting at. But still, do I need to be having that extra sugar right now? No, I do not. So no more on that, no more cookies, no more pasta. When I say it like that, it sounds like, oh my God, what has she been doing? It's not, I don't feel like it's that bad, but my body's just really sensitive to that. I have a history of polycystic ovarian disease. I have Hashimoto's thyroiditis. You know, these are things that already cause you to struggle with weight loss and retain weight very easily. I've always had to be careful about these things when I worked on this on myself for many years prior to making the decision to have weight loss surgery. I became very aware of what my body could and could not tolerate. So I think some of my disappointment is also that I thought having this surgery would give me a little bit more freedom in that realm. I thought, well, if I'm moving my body more again and I'm having my tiny little meals, that I could be able to eat things like pasta more often. And I say more often, I mean more than once a month. But maybe not, and certainly not right now. So now that the holidays are done, going forward, I just know I need to get back to measuring. I need to start drinking more water and just slowly increasing my endurance and take care of my body, how I'm feeling overall. But, you know, just that realizing, like, I had the surgery, I'm still in my body, I still have those things that were challenges before. Just because I had a bunch of my stomach removed doesn't change those other hormonal and endocrine factors for my situation. So moving forward, you know, that's what I'm going to do. I am going to be consistent about measuring my portions again, going to drop out eating all those simple carbs and get protein focused again. I'm still having a problem with eating some meat. So that's also been a challenge with protein intake, because I got so sick of protein shakes, so sick of them. And I like the Premier Protein, and I tried some other ones, but you just kind of get to that point where you're so sick of drinking your protein. And since I was having a hard time with eating my protein as in regards to meats, I just wasn't. And I need to be creative again. I love to cook and I am a good cook. And there are many recipes that I could do with beans and also tofu and things like that if I can't tolerate meat yet as much. And I do fine with chicken. So, I need to just go back to
Right.
that. So I do hope that everyone is doing super well out there. I hope everyone had a nice Christmas and you have a wonderful new year. Not a lot to report right now. Just feel like a big fat failure at this point. But hopefully, I'll get back on it and my weight will start moving in the right direction. Hopefully by 3 months, I will have some better news for you guys and have a little bit more weight loss under my belt. And I just want to say thank you for all of you guys who have been so supportive. The last I checked, I was up to 125 subscribers. I was like, wow. So just thank you so much. Shout out to all of you who have just been really great and supportive and all your wonderful comments. I appreciate y'all so much. And so sorry if I'm a little bit more somber in this video. Just a little disappointed. Just a little disappointed in myself falling off the food wagon. And a little just disappointed that, my weight loss hasn't been great this month. But, it's still, I have to look at like 35 to 37 pounds in 2 months is better than nothing at all. And it's certainly better than gaining. So I do hope everyone's great out there. You all have a good night, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.